James Webb captured its first images and spectra of Mars. The telescope provides a unique perspective with its infrared sensitivity on our neighboring red planet. Complementing data have been collected by orbiters, rovers, and other types of telescopes. But Webb's unique observation posts nearly a million miles away at the Sun-Earth Lagrangian point 2, L2, and it provides a view of Mars, observable disk, the portion of the sunlit side that is facing the telescope. As a result, Webb can capture images in spectra with the spectral resolution needed to study short-term phenomena like dust, storms, weather patterns, seasonal changes, and in a single observation, processes that occur at different times, daytime, sunset, nighttime, in a Martian day. Because it is so close, the red planet is one of the brightest objects in the night sky in terms of both visible light, which humans can see, and the infrared light that Webb is designed to detect. This poses special challenges to the observatory, which was built to detect the extremely faint light of most distant galaxies in the universe. Webb's instruments are so sensitive that without special observing techniques, the bright infrared light from Mars is literally blinding, causing a phenomenon known as detector saturation. So, this is what happened. Astronomers adjusted for Mars's extreme brightness by using very short exposures, measuring only some of the light that hit the detectors, and applying special data analysis techniques. Webb's first images of Mars, captured by the near-infrared camera, show a region of the planet's eastern hemisphere at two different wavelengths, or colors of infrared light. This image shows a surface reference map from NASA and the Mars Orbital Laser Altimeter, MOLA, on the left, with the two Webb NIRCam instrument field of views overlaid. The NIRCam shorter wavelength 2.1 micron image is dominated by reflected sunlight and thus reveals surface details similar to those apparent in visible light images on the left. The rings of the Huygens crater, the dark volcanic rock of Syrtis Major, and the brightening in the Hellas basin are all apparent in this image. The NIRCam longer wavelength, 4.3 microns, in this image, the lower right shows thermal emission, light given off by the planet as it loses heat. The brightness of 4.3 micron light is related to the temperature of the surface and the atmosphere. The brightest region on the planet is where the sun is nearly overhead because it is generally the warmest. The brightness decreases toward the polar regions, which reserve less sunlight, and less light is emitted from the cooler northern hemisphere, which is experiencing winter at this time of the year. However, temperature is not the only factor affecting the amount of 4.3 micron light reaching Webb with this filter. As light emitted by the planet passes through Mars's atmosphere, some get absorbed by CO2 molecules. The Hellas Basin, which is the largest well-preserved impact structure on Mars, spanning more than 1,200 miles or 2,000 kilometers, appears darker than the surroundings because of this effect. NASA also released Webb's first near-infrared spectrum of Mars, demonstrating Webb's power to study the red planet with spectroscopy. We have a whole video about that right in our playlist. Whereas the images show differences in brightness integrated over a large number of wavelengths from place to place across the planet at a particular day and time, the spectrum shows the subtle variations in brightness between hundreds of different wavelengths representative of the planet as a whole. Astronomers will actually analyze the features of the spectrum to gather additional information about the surface and atmosphere of the planet. So we're super excited to see what's coming next. This infrared spectrum was obtained by actually combining measurements from all six of the high-resolution spectroscopy modes of Webb's near-infrared spectrograph, NIRSpec. Preliminary analysis of the spectrum shows a rich set of spectral features that contain information about dust, icy clouds, what kind of rocks are on the planet's surface, the composition of the planet's atmosphere, the spectral signatures, including deep valleys known as absorption features of water, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide, which are easily detected by Webb. So, in the future, the Mars team will be using this imaging and spectroscopic data to explore regional differences across the planet and to search for trace gases in the atmosphere. including methane, hydrogen chloride. And if you want to check out what scientists detected from Webb about the Big Bang Theory, then make sure to check this video right here. Otherwise, see you in the next one.